So here is Chicago. It's a 5-point game. Here's Jordan on the shot. Two and a lot. And it's on John Havlicek.
It's slashing there by Jordan. Gets up to speed in a hurry. Just impossible to stay in front of.
His second trip to the line. Do you remember, Greg, if you watched the standings very much when you played?
You know, we were always aware of it, and a lot of that had to do with the goals. I mean, I remember early in my career playing for the Knicks, you know, we were trying to win championships, and we talked a lot about home court and having that come postseason time. So you were absolutely aware of where you were because of the goals you set. But I think that also changes depending on who you are as a team. If you're a championship caliber team that's won it, and maybe you're in the midst of a dynasty run, it may not matter as much because you know how good you are. You can win no matter where the game is.
Spurs trail by 9. And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game. For him.
And guys, I think the best way to measure his performance these last 10 games is his effective field goal percentage, which has improved, a sign that his game is in much better shape than it was not too long ago.
Now here's Duncan. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Detroit.
He was really aggressive on the glass, too. He really racked up on the boards out there.
Here is Robinson. They trail by 9 points. A 3 from Leonard. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Parker. Leonard's got his second bucket of the night.
What I like about Kawhi's shot, no matter the distance, always seems to be on balance.
Pippen kicks to Jordan. To the inside, and it's Olajuwon with the jam.
Yeah, this is what